Hi guys, this is Vinash Sharma and in this session we will discuss the DAX functions total MTD, total QTD and total YTD in Power BI. Now first of all the total MTD evaluates the value of the expression for the month to date in the current context. It means in the financial year, which month is the latest one? It will pick the value on the basis of the expression up to the last date. Also generate the cumulative total and subtotal. As per the syntax, you can see, first of all, we have the expression and that expression returns the scalar value, single value. Then date type calendar, you can mention here, and the filter. So this is the key difference between the dates MTD and the total MTD. In dates MTD, filter option is not there, but in case of the total MTD, filter option is there. So you can mention or you can define the filter in this option. And the return type of this total MTD is the scalar value. Next is the total QTD. This is similar to the total MTD, but it evaluates the value of the expression for the dates in the quarter to dates. Means for quarterly, it evaluates the value of the expression for the latest quarter. Also, it calculates the cumulative total and subtotal. Then the syntax almost the same in the expression. Scalar value returns the then date type and the filter. You can mention the filter here. Then third is the total YTD. Total YTD, it evaluates the value of the expression for year to date. It means for the current year and up to the last date, it will evaluate the value of the expression. Also calculate the cumulative totals and subtotals. The syntax is, first of all, expression returns the scalar value, then date type, and column batch contain the date, you can mention here, and the filters, the boolean value and the year and date. This is optional, and if you do not mention and if you skip, then by default it say December 31st, but you can change the financial year. You can define the year other than December 31st year. So we will check all these one in the practical. We can check the total YTD, total QTD and total MTD with this diagram. As you can observe, we have the data for the 2 years, 1999 and 2000. So for us, the current context or current year is the 2000. This is the last one, and the latest month is the August. So last date is the August 15. If we calculate the total MTD, then from August 1st to the August 15, this is the total MTD. So all the value will be taken from August 1st to the August 15. And if we calculate the total QTD, it's a quarter. So for first quarter, second quarter and third quarter, then August, July and June. So this is the quarter, 3 months. So all the value for these 3 months will be taken for the total QTD. And if we calculate the total YTD, so here the current context, the current year is the 2000. So the whole value for this year, for value for the whole month will be taken for the total YTD. Before we start the practical, first of all, we check the data. We have an Excel sheet, then name of the product, pen, pencil, and then quantity sold, sales date, and gross sales. We have the data for the 2 years. Sales date from 1st January to 2019 up to the 31st December 2019. Then data, we have the data for the second year from 1st January to the 19th December 2020. Now let us do the practical. So as you can observe, the data already uploaded, product, quantity sold, sales date and the gross sales. Now we have a table. In this table, we have the dates, sales date and the quantity sold. So we create a new measure. Total MTD. Quantity sold. Then sales date. Now measure created, drag and drop in card. Already we have a card and the value is the 3238. Now drag and drop this measure in table. So now you can observe we have the cumulative total for each and every month from January 1st January to 19 to 20 35. This is the cumulative total, but 3238 value, it is coming from where? In the current context or current month, that is the December. From 1st December, this one 350. 30th November, last month, the total ends here. Now the new total starts cumulative, and that is a, it's a 3238 from 1st December to 19th December. Now we verify this figure. We take slicer. Then sales date. So it says date slicer. The minimum date is the 1st January 2019 and the maximum is the last visible date is the 19th December 2020. Okay. So in total MTD, it's in the current context, the last year 2020 and the last month, that is the December, and the last date is the 19th, last visible date. So now you can see the data in the left side. We have the data only for 1st December to the 19th December. And that's a cumulative total from 350, 362 and then 369. And finally, we have the 3238. So this figure matches with this the total MTD. Now, in total MTD, we have an option that we can apply a filter. Suppose sales product equal to say pen. Enter. So you can observe the figure change. Now the figure is the 2201. So we take one more slicer to verify again this one. In slicer product. So within this date range, if we check the product, say CPU, so only one CPU was sold in December in this total MTD. If I check pad, then these are the figures. And if I check pen, then so you can observe 2201, because we applied a filter with the measure and the slicer is also working with the same way. So now these are the figures which were sold in December total MTD. Now we create the next measure, total QTD. The measure created, now drag and drop in card. So figure is 18294. And now drag and drop in table. Okay. So last quarter from October to December, last visible date 19. So we have the date in the slicer. And now we check 1st October. From 1st October, then we have the cumulative total 15 and 1999 2014, then next cumulative, then and finally we have the 18294. This is the matching figure for this period. Now same thing we can do, we can apply the filter with this total QTD. Pen and now. So filter applied. Now we can check with slicer pen. So this is the figure 2821. Total QTD with the filter pen 2821. Now we create the next function, total YTD. New measure. Quantity sold, then sales date. Then filter, say mouse. The measure created, drag and drop this measure in the card. The amount is the 15030, and also drag this one in the table. Now, so this total YTD, it means current context, current year is the 20, and means from 1st Jan to 19 December last visible day. So now in the left side, you can observe the data from 1st Jan to the 22, and the last is the 19 December, and 15030, this is the cumulative total of all these figures for the this YTD. Now this is for the mouse, because already we applied the filter mouse. Okay, now there is a one more parameter that is optional, end of year. End of year means, suppose if you do not mention, you skip this optional parameter, then by default it's a 31st December, and now you want to end the year say March 31st, then you can mention here say 3 then / 31st March and enter key. So you can observe the figure change. Now the figure is a 10855. So now we change the slicer and we make it 4, because 31st is the last one. So you can observe from the 1st April. Now the period is the 1st April, and you can observe this is the cumulative for the YTD. And finally we have the 10855 in case of the if the end year is the 31st March. So this is how you can use these three functions. So guys, this was all about the total MTD, total QTD and total YTD. Thanks for watching the video.